Hey, what's going on, y'all? So let's talk about the crazy ones. You know, the ones who want to cut you because you're playing with their emotions, or the ones who want to argue about every little thing instead of both of you sitting down and talking about it like adults. I want to talk about them, but mainly I want to talk about how you deal with that type of behavior. And the best way to deal with that type of behavior is not to deal with that behavior at all. But if you find yourself in that situation, you have to become emotionally intelligent. Meaning, you don't react off your emotions. You don't let your emotions think for you. Your emotions, they need to be filtered. And when you feel a certain way, your emotions are filtered through your thoughts or through your brain. You think about how this will affect my future, or how this will affect her future before you act on it. As a leader, to do that, you develop a kingship attitude about yourself. Not to be arrogant, I'm not saying that, but just to show that you are above the small stuff. You are aware of everything that's going on, but understand that everything doesn't deserve a reaction or a response from you. And I'm telling you, this skill is extremely important when it comes to dealing with more than one woman. Because, bruh, if you think one woman is emotional, try dealing with a couple of them. If you're not emotionally stable, if you're not emotionally intelligent, you're going to lose it. There comes a time where, I don't know, it's like they want they're on an emotional roller coaster, and they want you to jump on that emotional roller coaster with them. As a leader, with that kingship attitude, she has to know that you're going to stand your ground. And once she's, you know, going through all her different feelings or emotions, she can come back to you. In any, like in a war or something like that, you know, when things are getting hectic, the subjects, they look to the leader to see if that leader is panicking. And if that leader's not panicking, it ensues calmness on them. That's who you have to be. But if you're emotional and she's emotional and y'all taking each other to hell, that's how people get hurt. And that's how people get killed. And it's far too many of us locked up from doing emotional dumb shit. You know what I mean? So, you know, just get at some thought. And don't let them have a cute face or a little body on them. Oh my God. She thinks that gives her free reign to spaz out when anything don't go her way. That's why it's important that you listen to them. In the beginning, when they're talking about, oh, he hurt me and I wish I would have punched him in the face, or he did this and I cut him, you're dealing with a psycho. And what that translates is, if you do this to me, I'm gonna cut you or I'm gonna punch you in your face. Man, that's one translation. But the other translation is, don't do this to me because this is what he did to me, and I'm trusting you that you don't hurt me. But I promise you, man, you're dealing with a psycho. And the truth is, all of them are crazy. It's just depending on how emotionally intelligent you are to deal with it. You know what I mean? So I had this dude who told me a few years ago that his girl sliced all four of his tires, and it turned him on that she did it. I don't understand that. I mean, I asked him, how could it turn you on? And he was like, it shows that she loves me. It shows that she loves me. And, you know, it worked for him. That toxic relationship worked for him. And if it works for you, fine. But the warning in dealing with those type of relationships is that it deadens the trust that you have for other people. So further relationships that you have, you won't fully trust that person because you went through something toxic. And it damages your own self self-esteem. You know what I mean? So, you know, what I think is, if we start setting standards for what we would deal with in a relationship, they'll stop spassing out. Like, we're leaders. Like, you know what I'm saying? God has naturally made us leaders. And if we're acting like they are, we're not being leaders. You have to display leadership for them to want to follow. You know what I mean? And really, I really truly believe that if we start setting different standards, they'll stop doing the behavior that they're doing. So this is advice, man. And again, I hope it helps. Y'all be safe.